Hi guys, James at RampantLionReviews again for you today with another beer review. For this one, we are going to stick to Japan and we're going to return to a brewery who I introduced you to only a couple of videos ago. And this beer was actually from a gift set that was very kindly given to me by Casey and Eric at Sotogami Akihabeera, who are now retired unfortunately. I've been trying to pester them to come out of retirement, but my efforts don't seem to be working. But this beer is from a brewery that I saw them review maybe a year or two ago, and I was very, very curious about them, and Casey was kind enough to buy me a gift set from the brewery just, you know, for coming to Tokyo, and I'm very, very pleased that I'm able to review these beers for you here on the channel. So I really hope that you guys enjoy my take on this one, and I always enjoy introducing you to these little random Japanese craft breweries. So for this one, we are going to return to Gunma Prefecture, and we're reviewing my second beer from the Tsumagoi Kogen Brewery. So this one is just actually called Ale, and from, you know, this is one of the weird things about this brewery as well. I reviewed the stout for you in the first video, and from what I gather, that one was previously called Irish Stout, and this beer, I believe, used to be called Real Ale, but for some reason, the guys at Tsumagoi Kogen have decided to kind of rebrand their beers. But my initial understanding of this, if it is the same beer as the Real Ale, it's modelled on the kind of traditional English Real Ales, and this guy comes in at 5% ABV. So, you know, when we say that it's modelled on the Real Ales, that's a very kind of broad term, because there are a lot of different English Real Ales. You know, you've got Golden Ales, you've got Bitters, you've got all of these kind of different things. So to be quite frank with you, I have no idea what to actually expect from this beer. But then again, that makes it a very, very interesting beer review. And again, this is kind of unusual, because a lot of these little G-Biru breweries that you get in Japan normally brew the German styles, you know, like a Weizen, a Pilsner, an Alt beer, sometimes a Kölsch, you know, something like that. So to find a kind of English Real Ale from one of these very small local brews, and even the stout that I reviewed for you in the last video, is very, very unusual. So yeah, really looking forward to this one, and I'm very curious to see what they throw up in this review. So I hope you guys enjoy my take on this beer. So anyway, as is usual with my reviews then, I'll tell you a little bit about the brewery. If you want to get straight to the tasting, just fast forward. All the usual links are in the description below. That's the brewery website, link to my other reviews that hopefully I can do in the future from Tsumagoi Kogen. I hopefully can get another couple of videos filmed before I have to leave Japan. But there's all the usual social media. If you want to see more beer reviews, do please consider subscribing to the channel. The whole channel, of course, has a geography-based tagging system, so you can go into the homepage and search for beer based on country, city, state, county, prefecture, whatever it is you're interested in. Do check out the playlist of beers from different countries. There is one there for all the Japanese beers that I'm reviewing for you, and that's being added to whenever I get the opportunity. And as always, please do get in touch and let me know some of the other beers and breweries that you guys would like to see me review. It's always great to hear from you guys that are watching the videos, and the support that you show the channel is hugely appreciated. So anyway, onto my brewery notes then, and to be honest with you, there wasn't actually all that much information available on this brewery. You know, some of these breweries are ridiculously difficult to find out different things on, but the Tsumagoi Kogen Brewery are based in Tsumagoimura, which is a small village of only about 10,000 people in Gunma Prefecture, out to the west of Tokyo. And this brewery is part of the Asama Takahara Brewery Company, who I believe also brew sake and things like that as well. But this village is known to be very, very fertile for growing vegetables because of the ash deposits from Mount Asama, and also for its cool climate as well. These kind of cabbage-based foods are part of their kind of local speciality cuisine, if you like. So if you go to the brewery restaurant, these are the kind of things that you're going to eat. And as I said, the brewery do have their own restaurant, which is called the Tsumagoi Takahara restaurant. This serves a variety of different pizzas and pastas, a lot of Italian food actually, which looks pretty good and authentic. And it also has these local Japanese dishes that are based on the local cabbage, which, as I say, is a speciality product. And the photos of the food actually look very, very good. When you come to Japan, one of the things with Italian food is that it is almost like a Japanese take on Italian food rather than being truly authentic Italian food. So bear that in mind if you ever come here. But yeah, I'd be very, very curious to go up there and try some of the different kind of cabbage things that they're doing, because they look really pretty good. And I do love in Osaka, and of course you've got different varieties in Hiroshima as well, the okonomiyaki that we get here, which is cabbage based. So yeah, be curious to go up to Gunma and see what different things they have up there. And Gunma, of course, is another prefetcher, which is very, very good for its sake and apparently for its craft beer as well. So yeah, if you get the chance, do have a go at some of these beers. They do have another range of craft beers, which is Gunma something, if my memory is serving me correctly. But you can get two gift sets from this brewery, basically. You get the Tsumagoi Kogen beers, and you also get the Gunma, the beers released under the Gunma label as well. So both from the same brewery, from what I understand. And the Gunma ones, I think, are more German-style beers, but they do have a couple of other random things in there too. So yeah, an interesting brewery, this one. If you look at the pictures of the brewery restaurant and stuff, it looks very, very nice. It's kind of a cross between a little bit of a German brauhaus, but also an English pub, an Italian restaurant. There's a whole host of different things going in there. So it's basically just a kind of Japanese take on the West. But these guys, the Tsumagoi Kogen guys, have, I think, 5 or 6 different beers that they release under this label, and if you get the chance to try them, I do recommend that you have a look at them. So yeah, let's leave it at that for the brewery history and get on to the actual tasting itself. If you want to learn a little bit more, I'll put the brewery website in the description for you below, and you can have a look at that for yourself. And of course, you can follow these guys on Instagram and Facebook and stuff like that too. So let's get on to the actual tasting of this beer itself. So as you can see, it's kind of similar to, it's pretty much the same actually as the artwork on the last one that I reviewed from these guys. It's got this very kind of cartoony take on local events. I mean, you've got the Mount Asama there, you've got pigs, you've got the cabbages there, and I'm guessing that the, you know, owls are fairly, you know, the owls are fairly common locally, and I'm guessing there's a lot of pig farming and things like that as well, because yeah, you know, the it just looks very, very cool. And I'm surprised with a nice piece of artwork like this that it isn't more kind of widely distributed, to be honest. But this one does have a little bit of a top label on it, which is quite similar to the last one again, and there is the bottle cap, which seems to be a standard on all of these different Tsumagoi Kogen beers. But as I mentioned earlier, this one comes in at 5% ABV, and from what I understand, this beer is modelled on the English Relios. But again, this is quite a broad term, and I really do not know what to expect from this one. So without further ado then, let's get it out and we'll get on with the tasting and just see what we get from this beer. Yeah, so nice little bit of smoke on the opening there, and we'll get it out and into the glass. So yeah, going by the colour, first off, I would be guessing that this one is probably somewhere along the lines of an English bitter. So yeah, in terms of its colour, then this guy is coming out, if I hold it up to the light, it's a very dark, well, not overly dark, but it's a nice sort of dark, almost blood orange colour. You can see there's a half finger of a frothy, I would actually say, fawn coloured head on this one, to be honest with you. It's quite a nice sort of medium fawn coloured head. One or two big bubbles sticking towards the side of the glass, and a few little ones heading up towards the bottom of that head there. But you know, if you poured this guy, pardon me, into you know, if you poured the, you know, if you had this guy as an English Relio, you would think this is either a golden ale or a bitter or something like that. You know, in terms of colour, it does really kind of fit in that. The other thing that this guy possibly could be is an English pale ale, because it is along the same kind of colour lines for that. But yeah, in terms of an English Relio, I think leaning in towards the golden ales, the pale ales, or perhaps, you know, some kind of English IPA. So yeah, let's take a closer look at the aroma and just see what we get from this one, and maybe we can narrow it down on the styles before we actually taste the beer. So yeah, with this one, it's got a really kind of grainy, bready quality to it. There's a little bit of brown sugar in there, you know, almost like these McVitie's digestive biscuits that I always talk about. It's got that nice sort of biscuity, syrupy quality to it. A little bit of a toasty brown sugar in there. It's almost a little bit like caramel. And I would say, you know, definitely a bit of a kind of almost brown bready quality. It's not like rye bread like some of these, you know, it's not like a German rye bread or anything like that. It's more like a kind of wholemeal brown bread that you would get back in Scotland, actually. I'm not sure how good a descriptor that is for those of you watching in different countries, right enough, but definitely a nice sort of a more grainy, brown bready quality coming out of this beer. And that's one of the things as well, in terms of the aroma, I could hazard a guess that this is something similar to an English bitter, because it definitely has that sort of aroma profile to it. You've got a little bit of an earthiness from the hops in there, a little bit of an almost herbal quality as well, which would make me think that there's English hops in here. And, you know, I would hazard a guess that that is the case with this one, because just of that herbal quality that the beer has. You know, the English hops have this very distinctive, slightly darker earthiness, but also that smooth herbal quality. There's a little bit of a floral aroma from this one, and a little touch of grassiness in there as well. But to me, overall, the aroma makes me think this beer is leaning towards an English bitter, but it may well have an element of English IPA in there as well, just because of that slightly stronger sweet caramel and biscuit note. Yeah. So yeah, just take a little bit of time and enjoy the aroma of this beer before you get stuck in. But this one's definitely made me very curious. I think this one's either going to be an English IPA or it's going to be an English bitter. So let's take a taste of it and see how we get on. So this one is just the ale from Tsumagoi Kogen in Gunma Prefecture here in Japan. Let's get stuck in. Slange at school. Once again, thank you to Casey for providing this beer to review on the channel here. Kanpai. English bitter. Definitely an English bitter for me. But at the same time, it's one of the sweeter English bitters that I've come across before. And to be honest, what I'll say is that the English bitter is a style that I've never been a huge fan of. But that said, some of the examples that the Swedish brewed English bitters I've found have been very, very nice. And this one actually is pretty interesting. It's definitely a slightly sweeter variant. The Swedish brewed ones that I've had have always had the American hops in them, which have given them that little bit more kind of complexity. And this Japanese one is a little bit more malty, which is, you know, at the opposite end of the spectrum. So this is, you know, quite an interesting beer to review, actually. And one of the things I would say about this is that this is a beer, it's bottle conditioned, this one, obviously. I think this would turn out very nicely on these, you know, English pooled casks, which is obviously what the recipe of this beer is designed for. I think it's fair to say that. This one, it will have a little bit more of a kind of crispness to the mouthfeel because it's bottle conditioned compared to how it would come across in the bottled version. So just bear that in mind when you're tasting this beer. So yeah, with this one, I would say, again, it's got this nice, smooth, bready malt base to it. There's a little bit of a grainy quality to this one as well. The further you go into the aftertaste, a little bit more of that grainy aroma starts to come out of the beer. And it does get just that little bit drier because of that grainy bitterness that the beer has. In the very centre of your palate, you can pick up, there is a slightly sweet caramel to this one. And it does have that little element of kind of toastiness to it as well. At the same time, you've got a little bit of sweet, of a kind of biscuity sweetness, and again, it reminds me of these McVitie's digestive biscuits in there. But definitely in terms of its flavour profile, this is an English bitter. There's no doubt in my mind about it being an English IPA or anything like that. This is most certainly an English bitter beer. It is quite a nice example of the style. And this is one that I certainly could drink. And, you know, it says a lot for me because, again, this is a style that I have always said I don't particularly enjoy. And for me, when it comes to English, really, or the porters, the stouts, and even the milds at certain points are better than the bitters and the golden ales. But the bitter, I think, is one that is growing on me a little bit the further into this style adventure a little bit. So maybe I need to be a little bit more open-minded with this style right enough, but it is a good example. And again, it's very interesting to see a Japanese brewery trying to brew something like this, because mainly it's the German styles of beers that these little GB brew breweries will brew, and this is a very good example of an English bitter. In terms of the hoppy side of the beer then, in the back corners of the palate you've got a little bit of earthiness there, quite a distinctive English earthiness, to be honest with you. I'm pretty sure there's English hops in this beer. So yeah, a little bit of a darker earthiness there. As you move further forward, it smooths out and becomes a little bit more herbal. Towards the front of the corners of the palate, you've got a nice slightly floral quality to the beer then. Around the very front curve of the tongue, it's just a little bit lighter and grassy in there as well. And behind the front curve of the palate, you've got that little oily bubble where those juicy fruity esters start to come out of the beer. And for me, the fruity esters in this one, there is a little bit of a grassy citrus in there, but it really is leaning a little bit more towards the kind of red fruity side of things. So yeah, a little bit of a, I would say a kind of figgy ester to this one. Maybe a little bit of a kind of candied strawberry too. It's figgy in the beginning. It has a little bit more of that juiciness you'd expect of figs. But again, this one really reminds me of these little heart-shaped sweets you get in Haribo Star Mix. It definitely has a little bit of that in there. And it's very interesting how this flavour kind of interacts with the how it interacts with the kind of grassy citrus that you get from this beer. But overall, this is just a really, really nice, more malty take on the English bitter. It's definitely a little bit sweeter than the English brewed English bitters that I've had before. Odd thing to say that, but yeah, this one's definitely a little bit sweeter than those English brewed English bitters that I've had. And it's a very nice beer, this one, and it's cool to find a Japanese brewery brewing something like this. So yeah, have a go at this for yourself and just see what you think. This, again, this is another beer that's making me rethink my opinions on the English bitter. So I do wonder if I should review a couple of these different ones for you here on the channel and just see how we get on. You know, maybe it's opening my mind a little bit, this beer, which is always a very, very cool thing. In terms of the mouthfeel then, definitely a mid-bodied beer. Carbonation is very, very smooth. The mouthfeel overall is a little bit oily. Again, with this beer, I think this is one that's obviously designed for the cask conditioning rather than the bottle conditioning. The bottle conditioning is going to make it a little bit more crisp, but you've got a nice little bit of bitterness from the hops. I'd guess it's somewhere around the, you know, the 40-ish IBU mark. There's a little bit of bitterness coming from the grainy side of the beer. There's a little bit coming from the hops as well. There's a good little bit of sweetness in the middle of the palate as well from the malt base, and a little bit of a kind of juicy fruity quality to this one as well. And overall, it's got everything you would want from the style. But I think probably if you really want to see what this beer is all about, have it on tap at the brewery. But unfortunately, that's not something that you can do easily, especially if you're a European like me. But again, overall, very nice example of the English bitter style, slurring my words a little bit in this review. But yeah, a really nice example of the English bitter style, and I'm glad that I've been able to review this for you. So once again, thank you to Casey at Sotogami Akihabeera for providing this beer, and I really hope that you guys have enjoyed my take on this one. I really probably need to go back to the English bitter style a little bit more and review a few more of the kind of pinnacle ones and be a little bit more open-minded on it, because you know, the more of this style that I try, I think the more that I start to like it. So we'll see about that on the channel over the next little while. But yeah, let's leave it at that for this one. So this one was the Tsumagoi Kogen Ale. I think this beer is also known as the Real Ale as well. Do let me know about that in the comment section below. But thank you again for watching my beer reviews. And this has been a very, very interesting one for me to review for you as well. So again, do check out my social media. Let me know your own thoughts on this beer in the comments section below. And make sure you try some of these Tsumagoi Kogen beers, because they're producing some really quite interesting stuff and some styles that aren't quite well as well known in Japan, I think it's fair to say. So one of the little G-beer breweries that you really should check out. So thank you again for watching my reviews, and I will catch you guys very soon with more. This one is the Real Ale from Tsumagoi Kogen in Gunma Prefecture in Japan. Until the next time, Slanja, school, Kanpai. Make sure you check out my friends Casey and Eric over at Sotogami Akihabeera. Kanpai.